So people often ask, do I have to drain all the old coolant and water out of the system? Short answer is yes. The reason being, too much water in the system, you're going to lower your boiling point of the coolant, and you're going to have more risk of corrosion. An ideal conversion should consist of 3% or less water in the system. Once you do the conversion, you test it. If it's still over 3%, what you're going to want to do is drain out some of the coolant, add some new Evans waterless coolant to this system, retest, make sure you're below that 3% mark. The conversion process is pretty simple. It's a couple easy steps. Your first process you're going to do is you're going to drain out all of the old coolant and water. What we typically do is blow air through the system. You want to blow air through your hoses, the radiator, blow out your heater core. If you can get to the block drains on the engine, drain it through there and blow some high volume air through the whole system. Once you do that step, you're going to fill it with the Evans prep fluid here. You're going to run it. You want it to go through a heat cycle. It's going to absorb all the residual water and coolant. Once you go through that process, drain out the prep fluid, and then you're going to be ready to fill it with the Evans waterless coolant. We're often asked, how often do I have to replace Evans coolant? It really depends on conditions and the use of the vehicle. In most cases, like a car museum, car collectors, where the cars sit for a very long period of time, the coolant's going to typically last life of an engine. One way to check and make sure your coolant is still good, make sure you're still below that 3% mark, you can use a refractometer, which we offer on the website. Another way, we also offer free sampling programs. So at any point in time, you can send us a sample of your coolant, we'll test it, and we'll get the results back to you as soon as possible.